Okay, so now is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I've taken only, I've explained only with one example, but the same concept may be applied to all these mechanisms. This one, okay. So all these mechanisms are constrained because of the shape of the linkage. And because they are constrained because of the shape or form, they are all form closed. Whereas this one, it is not constrained because of the shape. It is constrained because of the external force. And hence, this is not form closed. This is force closed or successfully constrained. Successfully constrained. Fine. Okay. So, let's go back to the beginning of the class. So, we have discussed about the links and the different types of links. We have also discussed about the joints and the different types of joints. Now let us discuss about these other things. Let me pick this up. Please copy this. Continue this discussion. Okay. So now, what is a kinematic chain? What is a kinematic chain? Right. What is a linkage? What is a mechanism? And finally, what is a machine? So all these we have to discuss. Now, let us say first let us discuss about the linkage, right? Because it is more basic compared to the kinematic chain. So a linkage is any set of links, any set of links connected such that motion is possible, such that relative motion is possible. Okay, so you can take any set of links, fine. So let us say I'm taking these, how many links are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 links here connected by 5 revolute joints. So this can also be called as a linkage. Even this can be called as a linkage. But there is no definite motion possible. How many degrees of freedom does it have? It has 2 degrees of freedom. Because 2 links can move independently to each other. 2 links can move at same time independent of each other. That's why I'm telling this has 2 degrees of freedom. And even this can be called as a linkage. Fine. Any connection of links, even if it is open, let us say I'm connecting it like this. Fine. So there are 3 links here connected like this. 1, 2, and 3 links. And there are 2 joints. Fine. There are 2 joints. So even this connection of links can be called as a linkage. So there is no hard and fast rule for the linkage. Any number of links, whenever we are connecting them, they form a linkage. But now, not every linkage can become a kinematic chain. Fine. So if you want to get a kinematic chain, then definite motion has to be possible between them. Definite motion has to be possible between them. So let me take the example here. So I've created a lot of 3D models here for you to make it easy for you to interact with these models and check out how the motion occurs. So here you have a 4-bar mechanism, you can see. And if I'm moving the red link, the blue link is also moving along with it. If I'm moving the red link, the blue link is also moving along with it. That means the motion of these two is dependent on each other. The motion of these two is dependent on each other. And that's why we can say that this mechanism, this is a kinematic pair. This is a kinematic chain, sorry. Kinematic chain. So this can be called as a kinematic chain. So why? Because when this link is moving, the other link is also moving. So these two motions are dependent. Fine. Whereas here, the motion of 1 and 4, they are independent. So both can move at the same time, wherever they want to move. Okay. That's why this is independent, whereas this is dependent. Okay. So this is what I wanted to explain here. And hence, this one is a kinematic chain. Whereas this one is not a kinematic chain. This is just a linkage. Okay. This is a linkage, but not a kinematic chain. Whereas this is a linkage as well as a kinematic chain. So now with this discussion, what do you understand? Is every linkage a kinematic chain?
No, sir.
No. But is every kinematic chain a linkage?
Yes, sir.
Yes, very good. Fine. So this is what we should understand from this discussion. Next, let us come to a mechanism. So what is a mechanism and how is it different from a linkage or a kinematic chain? So I've told you that a kinematic chain is obtained from a linkage, because every kinematic chain is a linkage. So a kinematic chain is a special type of linkage, we can say. Kinematic chain is a special type of linkage. Whereas a mechanism is a special type of kinematic chain. So the same mechanism, let us take the same mechanism, select this. Let's take the same kinematic chain once again. So now, if I want to convert this kinematic chain into a mechanism, what should I do? I just have to fix one of the links. Now, in kinematic chain, all the links can move. In the kinematic chain, all the links are free to move. No link is fixed. That's when it is called a kinematic chain. But when I take a kinematic chain, and when I fix one of the linkages, so this link has become fixed link. So this fixed link is also called as a frame. So when I take a kinematic chain and when I fix one of the links, when I convert one of the links into a frame, that's when we get a mechanism. Fine. So here in this 3D model that I have prepared, you can see that the green link has been fixed. Now, if I unfix this, particular link, then every link can independently move. So when none of the links are fixed, then what we have here is a kinematic chain. We have a kinematic chain. Fine. So you can see that when I'm trying to rotate this, the motion is not getting transmitted. The whole kinematic chain itself is rotating. Fine. But as soon as I fix one of the links, now you can see that the green link has been fixed here. And now when I try to rotate one of the links, what is happening? So that is how we can convert a kinematic chain into a mechanism. Kinematic chain into a mechanism. Did you understand? Now a few questions. Is every mechanism a link a kinematic chain? Is every mechanism a kinematic chain? Is this mechanism a kinematic chain?
Can you explain once?
Yes, ma'am.
That kinematic to mechanism, sir. Can you explain once again?
Okay, I'm explaining once again this thing. So here you can see this is a four bar mechanism, right? Now they are connected. There are four joints. There are four linkages. They are connected like this. And each of these links, when I want to move, I can just click on this and drag it. I think the video is slightly lagging. So you are able to hear my sound before you are able to see the change happen on the screen. Okay. So that's probably one of the reasons for confusion. Anyway, so you can see the green link has been fixed. This symbol here, which is present, that is showing that the linkage is fixed. Increase this so many things. Okay. So I hope now you're able to see more clearly. Here, the symbol which is there, that is showing me that the part is fixed. So the green part is fixed. So when the green part is fixed, we can transmit the motion from red link to the blue link. We can transmit the motion from red link to the blue link. But when this is not fixed, when this is not fixed, let me unfix this. When this is unfixed, then you can see the motion is happening randomly. Every link has its own way of moving. And when I'm rotating this one particular link, the motion is not getting transmitted. I cannot definitely assume how the motion is getting transmitted. And hence, this right now, when none of the links are fixed, this is called as a kinematic chain. But when I'm fixing one of the links, now if I try to rotate a linkage, you can see the motion is definitely getting transmitted. So this is when I can call it as a mechanism. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Clear.
Okay. So coming back to the question, is every mechanism a kinematic chain? Can we call the mechanisms as kinematic chains?
Yes,
we can call all the mechanisms as kinematic chains. But can we call all the kinematic chains as mechanisms?
No, sir.
Only some of the kinematic chains can be called as mechanisms. Only those kinematic chains for which one of the links is fixed, only those can be called as mechanisms. So not all the kinematic chains are mechanisms, but all the mechanisms are definitely kinematic chains. Now, one more question. Are all the mechanisms linkages? Can we call all the mechanisms as linkages? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, all the mechanisms can be called as linkages, right? Then, that's it. So we can say that a mechanism is a special type of kinematic chain. Can I say that?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So these kind of questions may appear in the exam, and you should be able to answer them. Now, going to the next stage. Now, a mechanism can become a machine. So what is the condition for a mechanism to become a machine? Anyone?
There should be more than one mechanism.
There should be some useful work output. Okay. There should be some useful work output. When you are doing some work output, using some resources, fine. So some kind of energy or motion is available at one of the linkages. You are transmitting it to another point. That's what a mechanism does. But what a machine does in addition is, it will provide some useful work output. Fine. If the same mechanism can provide you with some useful work output, then we can call it as a machine. Okay. But if it is not giving out some work output, then it is just a mechanism. Fine. So a number of mechanisms can be combined together to form a machine. So a single machine can have more mechanisms. Fine. So if you take up a clock, a clock has how many mechanisms? Have you seen the mechanism? Nowadays, of course, the clocks have become digital. So I'm not talking about the digital clock. And also I'm not talking about the clocks which are running on cells. So the clocks which are running on cells, clock. They will have some motor. Yes. I'm talking about the old clock, the analog type of clocks, which had a key present here, and we had to load the clock from time to time in order to run it.
So one that clocks, has a pendulum.
Okay, that is also one example you can give. Even wristwatches also, they used to have a knob at the end, which we had to continuously load. Fine. I have seen some watches which automatically get charged based on movement of the of our hand also. Fine. So because we'll be moving our hand from time to time while we are doing the work, so that motion itself is used to charge the spring, and the watch will be continuing to work. So a lot of gear mechanisms and all will be present here to make this watch working. So a number of mechanisms are working here to give some useful output. The useful output is showing and maintenance of time. Fine. So this machine is showing us the time. This is its work output. And hence, we can call this watch as a mechanism. We can call this watch as a machine. Now, this machine is made up of a number of mechanisms. It will have a number of gears present in each within itself. So each set of gears can be called as a mechanism. Now, a watch uses a number of such gears interconnected, which are working together. Okay. A number of gears together, which are working together. That's what is used by the watch. And it is giving us some useful output, that is the showing of time. Similarly, if you take up an automobile engine, if you take up, then the source of power, what is the source of power for an engine? It is the fuel that we are putting into it. It is the source. The fuel is the source. Now, this fuel, we are using combustion. Fine. Combustion of the fuel we are using. And this is available as pressure energy. This gives us the pressure energy. So this pressure energy, we are using it with the use of piston to get reciprocating motion. Reciprocating means the piston will be moving up and down, correct? So if this is the cylinder, this is your piston, and there will be some walls and if there is a petrol engine, they have spark plug, and diesel engine will have some other arrangement, nozzle and all. So let's not shift our focus to that. So I'm talking about the fuel. So fuel is inserted into this. There will be a blast. There will be a blast in the fuel, and that gives us the pressure, and that pressure acts on the piston, and this piston can move down and up. So this upper and downward motion is called as reciprocating motion. So this reciprocating motion is converted into rotary motion. This reciprocating motion is converted into rotary motion. So this here is a crank. This here is a crank. So the crank will rotate. So as the piston is moving up and down, the crank will rotate, isn't it? We use a different color. Let's find it better. So this is the motion undergone by the crank, while this is the motion undergone by the piston. Okay. So this motion transmission is occurring here. Then this rotary motion is used for movement of the vehicle. Movement of vehicle. So this is the useful work output of the automobile. This is the useful work output of the automobile. Hence, automobile can be called as a machine. Automobile can be called as a machine. If you are just taking this arrangement, the cylinder, piston, connecting rod and crank, then they are just called as a linkage. If we are fixing one of the links, like this center point is fixed and also the cylinder is fixed, when these two are fixed, then they become a mechanism. And by using this mechanism, if we are able to get some work output, then it becomes a machine. Okay. So have you understood the definitions of machine, mechanism, kinematic chain and linkage? I hope everything is clear to you. Is this clear?
Yes.
Any doubts here?
No, sir.
No doubts. Okay. So let's see what we have next. So machine definition has been given here, and it consists of a set of one or more interlinked mechanisms, transmits and converts motion. It only converts available energy into useful work. Fine. So the point to be noted here is that a machine doesn't create its own energy. A machine doesn't create its own energy. It is just transferring or using the available energy into some kind of work. Okay. So in this particular case, in case of automobile, the energy is present in the fuel. The automobile is not creating its own energy. Even if you take a modern vehicle, let us say a solar vehicle. Fine. So you can say the Tesla car, if you are taking, it runs completely on electricity. So the car itself is not able to generate electricity. It has to take energy from some power plug. You have to plug it into the power socket, charge it, and only then it is able to move. So Tesla is also a machine, but of course it is not generating its own machine. So if you attach a solar panel on the Tesla, then again, you can say, in a way, it is appearing like as though it is generating its own machine. But the energy is actually present in the solar or the sun rays. The sun rays have a lot of energy, and that energy, the machine, Tesla car, is able to transmit and convert into the movement of vehicle, which is the useful work for us. Okay. So is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts here? Okay. Next, let us jump to the important point. Cuts back criteria. Okay. So Cuts back was a scientist who determined a method to find the degrees of freedom. Okay. So how to find the degrees of freedom for any mechanism? So a mechanism can be interconnected in various different methods. A mechanism can be interconnected in various different methods. So I'll stop this here. Start. In the next class, I will start here. Okay. You put a line in the middle. So in the next class, I'll start explaining. Ready? So in this previous class, we have learned all the terminologies that we'll be using in this particular subject. Fine. So all the terminologies and their definitions and how the definitions are interlinked, all this we have studied in this 1 hour from 9:30 to 10:30. So now, we are moving our discussion further into analyzing the types of mechanisms. Fine. So the first step in that is the cutback criteria. So let me start with a simple 2D links. So what do I mean by 2D links?
Degree of freedoms.
2D. Yes, ma'am. 3D links and 2D links. What are the differences? So a 2D link, if you are taking, it has only 3 degrees of freedom. One is upward motion, sideward motion, or rotation. These are the only 3 degrees of freedom that a 2D link can have. But if you are taking up a 3D linkage, then it can have upward or downward motion, left or right motion, forward or backward motion, and also rotation about x-axis, rotation about y-axis, and rotation about ZS. So how many degrees of freedom are there here? 6 degrees of freedom are there. Correct. So when I say 2D link, we can also call it as planar link. So planar link is constrained to its own plane. It cannot leave the plane. Fine. It cannot leave the plane. Whereas a 3D link has no such constriction. It can move in 3D space. And hence, this link can be called as spatial. So this is planar, this is spatial. This is 2D and this is 3-dimensional, 3D. Okay, so let's take an example of 2D first, because this is simple to understand. Let us take this example and try to see how the cutback criteria, how does it help us to find the equation for determining mobility. Mobility can also be called as degrees of freedom. So how to find the mobility or degrees of freedom for a mechanism? Okay, so let us start with some free mechanisms. So let us start with some free mechanisms. Okay. So there are how many links? How many links are there here? There are 4 links. Now, what are the total degrees of freedom for these 4 links? Total degrees of freedom. So each link has 3 degrees of freedom. So we'll have 4 into 3. That is 12 degrees of freedom. So each of these links can move upward as well as downward, left or right, and also it can rotate. Hence, all in all, we'll have 12 degrees of freedom. Now, let us do one thing. let us take this linkage. Let's take this linkage. Okay. Let's take this linkage and make it connected here. Let's take that linkage and make it connected here. Now, how many degrees of freedom are there? For 1 and 2 combined, how many degrees of freedom are there? How many degrees of freedom are there?
3.
Yes?
6.
3?
6.
So, these two links combinedly after making the joint. Fine. So, keep this in mind. We have made a joint here. Okay. So, first let us try to see how the second link is able to move. So, second link can move up and down, left or right, and also it can rotate. So there are 3 degrees of freedom for the second link. But now for first link, how many degrees of freedom are left? Can it move up or down? Can it move up or down, left or right?
If it is not fixed, it can move.
If it is not fixed, it can move. But now, because we have made a joint here, so because of this joint, can it move up or down, left or right?
No.
This motion is now not possible. So now the link number 1 has got constrained to link number 2. The link number 1 has now got constrained to link number 2. So now it cannot move up or down, but
It can still rotate.
So how many degrees of freedom does one have?
One.
Three.
Only 1 degree of
freedom.
Okay. So how many degrees of freedom are left for 1 and 2 combined?
4.
Yes, ma'am? 4.
4.
So 3 plus 1. So 4 degrees of freedom are left for 1 and 2. So now, For each joint, how many degrees of freedom are lost? How many degrees of freedom are lost?
For 1, 2.
For each joint, 2 degrees of freedom are lost. Again?
Yes, sir.
For each joint, 2 degrees of freedom are. Now let us take all these mechanisms.
For second one, sir, connected only, no, sir. Like these are having all 3 of them, no?
Sorry?
The second joint is having all 3 of the degree of freedoms, no? It has not got loosen any of them.
So right? One of them we have to give full degree of freedom, right?
Yeah. So, but here we are considering then, like for each joint, loss degree of freedom is 2.
Yes. So. Before formation of the joint, how many degrees of freedom were there for 1 and 3
for each?
Are you able to?
How many degrees of freedom were there before the formation of joint?
For each one of them was 3.
Each one of them was 3. So total, they 6. Had 6 degrees of freedom combined.
Yes.
But as soon as the joint was formed,
one has lost 2.
We had 4 degrees of freedom only.
Yeah.
Fine. So okay, we are just subtracting 6 minus 4.
Okay. Okay.
So 2 degrees of freedom are lost.
Yes.
So once again, if we do the same for the link number 4, if we are making a joint here. So here we are making a joint. So here also 2 more degrees of freedom will be lost. Right? Finally, we're going for the. Yes, ma'am? Sorry?
So if the joint is made between 4 and 1, then link number 4 will lose 2 degrees of freedom, right?
Yes. Link number 4 will again lose 2 degrees of freedom. Next. If we continue doing that process, if we make a joint here, again 2 more will be lost for 3. And if we make a joint here, then 2 more degrees of freedom will be lost. So each joint is making it lose 1 degree of freedom. So 2 into j I can use. 2 into j I can use. Can I use?
Sir, repeat this last step now, sir, please.
1 minute. Let me write this also differently. So instead of just putting the numbers, I will just put that as L. So what is L? L is number of links. Number of links. What is J? J here is effective joints. Effective joints. So I have explained effective joints, what they are, right? So here we are in this equation, we are using the effective joints. So J is the number of effective joints. L is the number of links. So total degree of freedom will be 3 into L. How many? The number of links multiplied with 3. We will get total degrees of freedom. And the lost degrees of freedom will be 2 into J. J is the number of effective joints. So here we are having how many joints? How many joints are we having here? 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we have 4 joints here. We have 4 joints here. And we have to multiply 2 with the number of joints to get the total degrees of freedom which are lost. Total degrees of freedom which are lost. Okay. So now, if we want to find the mobility, for mobility or for the degrees of freedom for the mechanism, what will be the formula? First, we have to find the total degrees of freedom for all the links when they are free. Then we have to make the joints one by one, and we have to subtract 2 multiplied with the number of joints. Okay. So this is where we get the mobility. So till now, it is still a kinematic chain. Till now, it is just a kinematic chain. It has not become a mechanism, isn't it? So how to convert this into a mechanism? How to convert this into a mechanism?
By fixing one link.
Yes. By fixing one of the links. So let me fix this link. Now, if I am fixing the link number 2, how many degrees of freedom it is losing?
All 3 of 2.
Yeah, no, all these 3 links, all the 3 degrees of freedom it will lose. Correct?
Yes.
All the 3 degrees of freedom, the link number 2 will lose. So we have to subtract 3 from it. Now this is fixed. This doesn't depend on the number of links. We are fixing only one link at the end. Correct? We are always fixing only one link. We are not fixing multiple links. So only 3 degrees of freedom will be lost when we fix one of the linkages, one of the links. So this will give us the mobility or degrees of freedom. Okay, for the mechanism. Is it clear? So now the same equation, we will be slightly modifying this. So we have 3 here as well as here. So we can take that 3 common, and what will be left in the bracket? L minus 1 will be left, and this 2j as it is, we will put here. Okay. Is this clear?
Yes.
How we got this 3L and 2J, sir? Yeah.
Yes, ma'am?
It's 3L and 2J.
3L and 2J.
Yeah, how we got that?
So this 3L is coming from here. Let me take a different color. Dark one. Okay. So this 3L is coming here. And this 2J is coming here. And this 3 is coming from the one fixed. This 3 is coming from the one fixed link. When we fix one link, it will lose all the degrees of freedom. All the 3 degrees of freedom will be lost. And that's why we are getting the 3.
Yes.
And this same equation we are converting here. So what we are doing is we are taking three common from these two.
And why are we subtracting
this? Because it is losing.
Okay.
In the first case, it is gaining the degrees of freedom. Hence, it is positive. Whereas in the second and third case, it is losing the degrees of freedom. Hence, we are subtracting. So the number of degrees of freedom left, we can calculate by this formula. We can calculate by this formula. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Very good. Okay. So now, if I give you some problems, you should be able to solve it. I give you some problems, you should be able to solve it. Okay. So let's take up this problem. And let us solve that. Okay. Ready?
Yes, sir.
Here. Let's go down. And let us now solve this. Ready? I'll take the same color. Yellow.
Fine. This is problem one.
Can all of you see the screen clearly?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I will stop sharing and once again share. I think some students are unable to see. If you are unable to see the screen, please let me know. It sometimes happens. This is a problem with Microsoft Teams. Because of some reason, the screen sharing will go off for some of the users. So if something like that is happening, please unmute yourself and let me know. Okay, I'll try to resolve. So I hope everyone is able to now see the screen.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
No, sir.
Let me take. Yes, anyone is unable to see the screen still?
Yes, sir, I'm unable to see it still.
Please check your connection. I have reshared the screen once again. Still, if you are unable to see, maybe there is a problem with your network. Please check it. Okay. So meanwhile, anyway, the recording will be available in the chat area. You can watch it later as well. So instead of wasting my time, let me just go ahead with the class. Okay. So you are getting my sound at least. Everyone is getting my sound. Is there anyone who is not getting the sound? No sound, anyone?
No, sir. We are getting your sound. You're audible.
So those who are getting, they will anyway get it. I'm talking about those who are not getting. If you're not getting, please let me know. Okay. Okay. So let's go ahead and try to use this. So this here, this diagram here will be given to us. And the question will be somewhat like this. Okay. For the kinematic linkages shown in the figure, calculate the following. So what is to be calculated? I think I've mentioned this in the notes here. Okay. So all these things you have to find. So let me take that as well. So all these things we have to find. All these things we have to find. Okay. Ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this diagram is given to us. And what is the formula? What is the formula? We have to use the Kurzweil relation. Kurzweil relation or Kurzweil criteria, we can call it. We have to use this. So what is the formula? Degree of freedom or mobility is equal to
m equal to 3l minus
l minus 1 bracket close minus 2. Correct. So this is the formula. Now one by one we have to define all these things. So we have to define l, we have to define, okay, so 2j now we have to define.
Yes,
l, we have to define j. So from the diagram, tell me what is the number of links, L. How many links do we have? Now the definition of link, you should know it. Definition of link is that no part on the link can have relative motion with respect to any other part on it. Fine. So when I say the number of links, link number 7 is 1. Fine. The number of links have been counted already here. In the diagram, you can see the numbers. So these numbers, they are counting the number of links. How many links are there here in this diagram?
8. Such.
8. Fine. So here you can see this triangle, this completely is one link. Fine. Because this is a triangle, it becomes a structure. Fine. Even if three different links are connected in the shape of triangle, then we can say that the triangle will become a structure. Fine. In this case, because he has hatched it, specifically he has hatched, we can assume that this is a link. So this is link number 1. Link number 2, this complete rectangle is link number 2. This complete rectangle is link number 3. This complete rectangle is link number, what is this link number? 4. Okay. Then this single line is 8. This single line is 6. Single line 7. Single line 5. Fine. So this is how we should count the links. So number of links, how many are there? 8 links.
Eight.
Right. 8 links. Now when I say J, I told number of effective joints. Number of effective. Yes, ma'am?
This line, the linkage parts, I didn't get it.
Number of links. Number of links. You see, 8 is the maximum number here, no?
Well, 7 and 5
is the maximum number here. Are you getting this?
No, sir.
8 is the maximum number.
Okay.
So the number of links are 8.
Okay.
And next, we have to count the number of effective joints. We have to count the number of effective joints. Are you able to see this? I think the color is very dark. Dark background.
Yes, sir. Joints.
Okay, let me write with yellow so you can see it. How many number of joints are there?
Nine.
Yes. Now number of joints, we have to count them. Okay, let us start counting. So here, how many links are joined here?
Nine, sir.
Only two links are joined, link number 1 and 7. One minute. Let me show for others. If you know the answer, write it in your book and be ready. Okay. So after explanation, I will ask. Let me see how many will answer correctly. Okay. Fine. So link number 1 and 7, they are both joined at this point. So this is first joint. And at this point, link number 2 and 1 are joined. So this is the second joint. At this joint, link number 2 and 5 are connected. So this is the third joint. At this joint, link number 3 and 5 are connected. At this joint, link number 3, 6 and 5. So there are three links connected here. There are three links connected here. So joint number 4 and joint number 5, both we will get here only. Because while discussing the joints, I had told you, if three links are connected at the same joint, the effective joints we have to count there are 2. So here we have to count 2 joints instead of just 1. Okay. Same way, at this point, how many links are joined? Link number 4, link number 6, and link number 7. All three links are joined at single place. So here also, we have to count 2 joints. So joint number 6, joint number 7. They are both here. Okay. Then, here, link number 4 and 8 are connected. So joint number 8. Here, link number 8 and 3 are connected. So joint number 9. Here, link number 3 and link number 2 are connected. So joint number 10, and here link number 4 and link number 1 are connected. So this is the 11th joint. So how many effective joints are there here? How many effective joints are there here? 11. Okay. So just check. Those you have written in your notes, just check if you are getting 11, if you got 11. If you didn't get 11, probably you have made the mistake here at the ternary joints. So at ternary joints, three links will be connected and we have to count them as two effective joints. Sorry. Okay. So number of links are 8, number of effective joints are 11. So substituting them in the formula, we get the mobility. So what is the mobility of this? 3 times 8 minus 1 minus 2 times number of joints, that is 11. So what do you get? 3 7 is 21 minus 22. Wow. Is there a mistake? 3 7 is 21. And 11. Achha, one more set is there, no? Minus 3.
So common, it was taken common before.
Yeah, of course. Achha, okay. It was taken common. So we are getting minus 1. How can that be? Did we go wrong anywhere? Please check it. One, two, three, four, and five, six, and seven. Yeah, three links joined here. Everywhere else, two links are joined. Yeah, we have not made any correct mistake here. Anyway, we are getting minus one. I don't know why. Let's take up the next problem and try to see if it is getting resolved. Okay, so let's take this next problem.
Sir, 5 and 7 are also triangle, no, sir?
But he has not hatched it, no? He has not hatched it. So for these, we should not count them as triangles. If we count them as triangles, number of links will change. Number of links will change. 1, 2... Yes, there are 8 links. Yeah, everything is correct. Okay. Let's come back to that in a while. Let's take up this next problem. That's better. Okay, now once again, let us count the number of links. Ready? So, you can see that there are these three points which are fixed. There are these three points which are fixed. So all these three will become a frame. All the fixed points will become a frame. And all the fixed points...
Mr. Srikanth, I just want to interact with students. Can you leave?
Yes,
and not to be recorded. This is not to be recorded. My interactions need not be recorded. I'd like to thank the students, right?
Stopping.
Thank you.